Welcome to our submission from Team No Code Continuum for Project Hack 18, Challenge 3. Here's the team. Our summary this time is that we're cataloguing goods and services using the UN codes. Now, this is a problem for every procurement function. It's very time consuming. Often they get it wrong, but it's a nightmare and it's limited added value. So can we create a system that improves the accuracy of assigning codes and drastically reduces the time it takes? Of course we can. And that QR code takes you to our solution. So the highlights of this solution, no code, obviously, taking only 30 seconds to get an answer for that busy analyst. We've used Microsoft Power Platform, Alteryx, and ChatGPT. It's a self-service solution for ad hoc requests that manages the fault tolerance for high demand API services like ChatGPT. We're batching solutions as well for people who need to update multiple at once. And as the AI gets better, so will our solution. And this is what development looks like. Using something like Alteryx to pull together an in-memory view of your on-prem and cloud data, pull it all together, and then use codes like ChatGPT in order to actually be able to come back with responses on demand without needing to write the code. So we've got an ad hoc mode. So let me just go through the actual, why don't we just go and fill in an example. So here's our website. We're hosting the Microsoft form there, GDPR notice. Fill in your details, mateo@continuum.je. Let's go next. What are we doing? Are we doing goods or services? In this case, we want a project data analyst, and we want an analyst who will use data to interrogate the project for better reporting and outcomes. As we know, data analysis is a fantastically valuable and growing discipline. So we just click on submit. Great, that's gone. So what's actually happening behind the scenes? So we've just filled in that form. Power Automate has sent that information via API to Alteryx, which has kicked off, and it's now gone and asked ChatGPT with a multitude of questions using prompt engineering, and then it's selecting the most likely response and then sending that via email to the user. The alternative model is using batch mode, where you'd have a file full of requests that Alteryx processes one after the other, then outputs the codes in whatever format is needed, plus an error file. So let's go and have a look at what the email was that we got back. And here we go. Hi, Mateo. Thank you. The code for this service is this number, and this is the description for it. And brilliant, right? You can try this yourself. Play around with the different prompts and things, and you'll see that it's very effective and quite sensitive, but reliable. So the persona summary. So for the project manager, right, we've just shown you. That's how you get a new code for any goods or services. Project reporter, you might well want to check all of your historic ones. That's what you'd use the batch mode for, and we've also back tested. And then the code assigner, well, the best news of all, you don't have to do that anymore. You're going to actually be able to spend time on the project and actually helping add more value to the project team and the client. Questions. So language model, potential issues around accuracy. As I mentioned, we did that back testing. If you want to know about potential issues for accuracy, you need to see what codes have been assigned to the data in the past. We'll be able to improve that. And really, that's what will come up in question three. Yes, as you've seen, we've gone from 2 hours to 30 seconds, and it's utterly repeatable and reliable. And finally, what would you do with more development time? Well, as I mentioned, we would probably use a machine learning model to actually do some pre-testing, learn from past scoring, past results, in order to then come up with our own model maybe. But for now, GPT is very, very good. And the fact that it's got the full product set for the UN goods and services is just miraculous. Thanks very much. Hope you've enjoyed our submission and look forward to seeing you next time. Thank you.